After the, you know, the Easter carnage, which is the evolution of the involvement of the Roman Catholic Church of Vatican through the Pope, right? I have earlier also pointed out, since the Pope who heads the Roman Catholic Church in the state of Vatican, supposed to claim, you know, to the give leadership to the Roman Catholic Church, you know, and the, its believers after the, you know, the murder of Jesus Christ by the Roman Emperor, right? Then how could the name be Pope? Whoever who says I am the next person after the Jesus Christ, right? Okay. And he call himself as Pope, and in that case, why this position is only limited to men? Why a woman can't be a Pope? Another question I like to ask. Now, in that case, why do you call Pope? Right, Pope has nothing to do, no name, with the name of Jesus Christ. So that is why the name must change. You know, not Pope, the Christ of Roman Christians. That is the best way. You know, you can't say Catholics. It must use the word Roman Christians, and not Roman Catholics. Because you Pope says I am the next leader after the Jesus Christ, and calls himself as Pope, so, and then name the believers as Roman Catholics, as not as Roman Christians, because the name Christians has CHRIS, which refers from the Christ, Jesus Christ. They don't like to use, because they are the ones who killed, murdered Jesus Christ, the Roman Empire at that time. So now, in this case, on the other hand, the Roman Catholic, when you look at that phrase, the two words, you know, the Roman means a state, it's an empire, it's a sovereign nation. As today we can see in Europe, the modern Roman, you know, the Roman Empire is European Empire. That is why the Europe had been joined together to make European Union, and that is why through the Brexit, you know, the referendum, the Great Britain, the United Kingdom, which is an Anglican Christian nation, exited from the, you know, Roman Catholic European Union, because Anglican Christianity and the Roman Catholic religion have two major rift between their viewpoints. Because Roman Catholics church says they are the believers of the, you know, the Jesus, you know, the saints and the statues, and also they murdered most of all the Jesus Christ, the empire, the Roman Empire. And the Anglican Christians do not associate themselves after the empire being murdered, empire, the Roman Empire, Europe murdering Jesus Christ. The Anglicanity evolved, and they, you know, split away from the major church, the Pope's church, in you know, which claim inheritance or the rights to the Jesus Christ after murdering the Jesus Christ. This is the why Anglican Christianity, you know, is more like different from the Roman Catholicism. And after all, they call it Anglican Christianity, and Roman Catholicism never used the word Christianity, and also it used the word Roman. So Roman means an empire. The empire means a big state of different countries, as we see today, the European Union. And that is why the Great Britain, United Kingdom, exited from the European Union, since it's a Roman Empire. In the modern world, under the pretext cover, hiding the correct, you know, the picture, you know, because they cover it up and they promote as European Union, but it's the Roman Empire that's still there in the modern world. And not only that, they use the Pope as its official leader to promote war, conflict around the world, you know, and attack similar personalities to Jesus Christ, as it's the Roman Empire, who assassinated the Jesus Christ and murdered him. So we can see under, you know, these the circumstances, the name Roman Catholicism must change, and rather than calling them Catholics, they must at least say Roman Christians. You know, if the Pope claims, you know, they himself, you as succeeded the Jesus Christ. So on the other hand, we can see the Roman means the state, an empire, a country. So, you know, such Roman Catholic Church in Sri Lanka actually is an embassy, a large embassy based, you know, of the Roman Empire, you know. And the Rome, and its priests are the political, you know, representatives of the Roman Catholic, you know, Roman Empire, the modern European Union, you know, using its religious branch, which is the main branches of democracy, means the legislature, here the European Parliament, executive, the European president, or in that case the Roman Catholic, modern Roman Empire's legislature, European Union, the modern Roman Empire, European Union's president is there, and the modern, you know, Roman Empire, the European Union's legislature, parliament is there, and the modern European Union, the Roman Empire's the religious branch is Roman Catholic Church, Vatican. That is why I proposed Sri Lanka's constitutional amendment to create a religious branch of all religions in this country, without any affiliations to any foreign political organization, on our own, an interpretation of the religion. That is Sri Lanka's own, you know, version of Hinduism, and the Hindu text, Sri Lankan Hinduism, without affiliation to Indian Hinduism, with headquarters in Kataragama, as a sovereign area to prevent future Sri Lankan political interference on the religion, and Sri Lanka's own Islam religion, Sri Lankan Islam religion, with headquarters in Aludgama, without affiliation to Arab Medina, or you know, the Mecca, you know, and also with the sovereignty in that you know, the Aludgama area, as the Sri Lankan Islam headquarters. And also the textbooks like Holy Quran, Hadith, and other textbooks, you know, being, you know, rewritten in a Sri Lankan context, and also without any affiliation to Arab, here once more, and also the Sri Lankan version of the, you know, the Judaism in Polonnaruwa, with our own version, you know, interpretation of the textbooks, with our Sri Lankan Judaism synod, without any reference to, you know, Israel, and also with a sovereign area in Polonnaruwa, also for Judaism, Sri Lankan Judaism, without, to prevent Sri Lankan politicians messing up with the Judaism religion here, and also Sri Lanka's own version of Christianity, with Sri Lanka National Church, without affiliation to the Roman Catholic Church, or neither to the Anglican Church, or thousands of other branches of Christianity, with Sri Lanka's own interpretation of the Holy Bible and the Jesus Christ's life, and also other religious related hymns and, you know, texts and everything, and traditions and practices, and also saints, etc. Here the saints must be only the Sri Lankan saints, incorporated as saints by the Sri Lanka's proposed version of the Christian, you know, church, with Sri Lanka's own head, you know, similar to the so-called Pope, the Christ of Sri Lanka, with independent sovereign area for its, you know, religious activities in Ragama present national seminary area of the Roman Catholic Church, and Roman Catholic churches, and the, you know, and the Calvary Church, you know, or Baptist Church, and the Methodist Church, and the of Sri Lanka, the Roman Catholic Church of Sri Lanka, the Anglican Church of Sri Lanka, the Calvary Church of Sri Lanka, the Baptist Church of Sri Lanka, the Methodist Church of Sri Lanka, all other thousands of different branches of churches must cease, and they must get as churches of the this proposed Sri Lankan version of the Christianity, with a Sri Lankan interpretation of the Holy Bible to suit our traditions, our culture, a religion for our people, because of the past huge war here and its damage, right? And because of the Easter carnage due to the involvement of the Roman Catholic priest in the war, right? And now continuous, you know, involvement in the Bopitiya church in Bopitiya Nigambo, using children for Muthurajara LNG power plant protest by the Roman Catholic priest, political priest in Sri Lanka. So to stop this, a sovereign area for Christianity, all versions, not to, you know, differentiate like that, because as Buddhists or Hindus or Muslims or Judaism followers, we cannot grasp a Christian religion, since according to Gautama Buddha, a Buddhist must respect others' religion. Respect means learn others' religion while practicing the Buddhism, a Gautama Buddha says. So how to learn others' religion when there are thousands of, you know, churches like Roman Catholic Church of Sri Lanka, and then Anglican Church of Sri Lanka, then the Calvary Church of Sri Lanka, then the Methodist Church of Sri Lanka, you know, etc., etc. So then, in that case, how to follow, which version to follow? We cannot, as Buddhists, respect, you know, these all thousands versions of churches in Sri Lanka. That is why we need a separate one Christian Church of Sri Lanka, scrapping all other churches to this and amalgamating to this, and no affiliation to Roman Catholicism Church in Vatican or Anglican Church headquarters in Canterbury to the Bishop, Archbishop of Canterbury, because Archbishop of Canterbury, who leads the, you know, the Anglican Christian Church in Canterbury, is actually the main priest, religious priest advisor to the Queen Elizabeth and the royal family. So that Canterbury Church is the headquarters of the Anglican Church, Anglican Christian in the world, you know, which splitted from the main Christianity at that time, the due to the murder issue of the Jesus Christ, and now that church is the officially the church that belongs exclusively to the Queen Elizabeth, right? And it is where the Princess Diana's funeral held also. So such duplicity-based churches we don't want here. We want our own church with our own leader, Christ of Sri Lanka, right? With no affiliations to foreign churches, okay? All of the churches are rejected, and this may, it must be established. And the Buddhism, the Gautama Buddha's teachings in Kandy, in around the Sri Dalada Maligawa, must be a sovereign, independent area, exclusively similar to the Kataragama for Sri Lankan Hinduism, Alutgama for Sri Lankan Islam, you know, Christianity, you know, the Ragama for Sri Lankan Christianity, Polonnaruwa for Sri Lankan sovereign, you know, Judaism, similarly sovereign area must be there in and around Dalada Maligawa in Kandy, for Gautama Buddha's teachings, which is known as Buddhism. Actually, the name Buddhism was not proposed by Gautama Buddha. It is a cultural, traditional evolution that happened after the passing of the Gautama Buddha. People label the teachings of Buddha as Buddhism. Rather, we must call teachings of the Gautama Buddha, not Buddhism. You know, and that teachings of the Gautama Buddha, you know, as a religion, must be preserved in Kandy in that sovereign area. This would prevent future, you know, these unethical, wrongful activities of President Mahinda Rajapaksa, that time son, Namal Rajapaksa, who organized, you know, car racing around the Kandy Lake, you know, adjoining the Sri Dalada Maligawa. Now, can you do car racing in the Vatican, Roman Catholic Church headquarters in Vatican, near the Pope's, you know, Roman Catholic Church? Or can you do car racing? I like to ask Nama Rajapaksa the same thing. Or can you do, in that case, at all, from Yochita Rajapaksa, since he's a graduate from the National Defense College in United Kingdom, as a naval recruit, he joined Sri Lanka Navy later when I protested that the political influence happens to the Sri Lanka Navy when the President's son is in the Sri Lanka Navy. He was shifted as the President's coordinator, President Mahinda Rajapaksa's coordinator. But still, he's still enlisted, right? As a commission officer, he may go back to Navy again. So this is a matter that has to be taken up under Sri Lanka Navy Act to stop these political people's sons, similar to the central bank's sons joining commercial banks, the President's son here joining the Sri Lanka Navy. Just because Ms. Shiranti Rajapaksa or Shiranti Vikramasinghe Ni, you know, father had been a naval commander, we cannot allow the President's or politician's, you know, sons, her son to join the Navy. No, that's a political influence in the military that we cannot allow according to the Constitution of Sri Lanka. Since Constitution of Sri Lanka, the Commander of Chief is the President. The President's son joining the Sri Lanka Navy, you know, results in a conflict of interest, because his son is there, then he's the commanding chief. Then obviously he will look into the interest of his son. If President's son at that time, you know, the Yoshita Rajapaksa was involved in Moolavaikkal Tamil genocide, then President, and he was get about to kill due to the Moolavaikkal Tamil genocide activities, operation, then he would order everything to save his life, right? His son's life, Yoshita Rajapaksa's life during the Moolavaikkal Sri Lankan Tamil genocide, then caused the genocide even. Because that's the conflict of interest according to English common law principles, which applicable to Sri Lanka. So therefore, the Yoshita Rajapaksa must be officially delisted through the Sri Lanka Navy Act. And on the other hand, what is important is, this way, we can have a sovereign, you know, independent, politically affiliated sovereign, right? right? So areas in Sri Lanka, Alutgama, Kataragama, Polonnaruwa, Kandy and Ragama for all five religions in the world, in the United Nations system, and follow them, right? That's very important to ensure, you know, peace and acceptance and followance of the religion in a good way, to avoid another war based on religion in Sri Lanka, as happened due to the influences of the Portuguese, Dutch and the British invasions, and the Islam, you know, migrations, and the Maulavi migrations from India, Malaysia and Arab nations, and also due to Hinduism, you know, priest, you know, migrations from India, because Hinduism, it says about five, you know, Hindu covers in the around the circumference of Sri Lanka before Prince Vijaya came. So what is the issue? We don't care about the Kovil. What matters is the people, the civilization, and the people who are who have run this country for 2500. The church, now Hindu Kovil could have, would, I don't know whether it was there, because we cannot prove them. It could have been there. Even if it was there, still, you know, before Vijaya, Prince Vijaya came, how can the brick and mortar cement, modern cement Kovil is important than the lives of the people? Just because there was a Kovil before, five Kovils around the circumferences of Sri Lanka, in Jaffna, Trincomalee, down south, and also Chilawo, and as I think other one, I cannot remember. So Jaffna, Trincomalee, down south, and Trincomalee, Mana and Chilawo. So just because of the, you know, there had been, like, you know, Hindu Kovils from, you know, before Prince Vijaya arrived, and on that basis say, okay, Sri Lanka, Tamil Hill, homeland in northeast. Well, what matters is who carried forward the civilization to flourish and life to exist in this country for 2500. It's a single Buddhist people, and just a brick and mortar Kovil there for even for 3000 or 8000 years. Since Hinduism developed more than 8000 years or 6000 years before the, you know, in the world history as the first religion. We don't care about the brick and mortar buildings in Sri Lanka's circumference, whether it's Munneswaran or Kodeswaran or wherever it is, right, around those five places. We care about the civilization that thrived here and flourished the future as well, the same way.